Matariki is the Pleiades, really. It's the cluster of stars that sits in the shoulder of Taurus, the bull. However, it's the Māori name and the name most commonly known throughout Polynesia and the Pacific for that group of stars. It has connections to Māori spirituality, Māori ceremony. It's connected to the environment, it's connected to food, it's connected to weather. It carries our dead across the sky. It also promises the bounty of the new year. And it was also a mark of the changing of seasons, so we knew when to herald in the new year. So the symbolism is, there's many, many facets to it.
And our ancestors will get up in the early morning of winter and look for the cluster. Now, best rights, if they're all spread far apart, it's going to be a great year, and if they're all clustered together, it's going to be a bad year. Tangaroa lunar phase just went up. The canoe rises. We throw our dead into the night sky just as the sun comes up. That begins our new year.
I was gifted a manuscript of my ancestors by my grandfather and told really to find a way to help disseminate this knowledge.
These are lunar months. They don't follow this. Pipiri is not June. Sometimes pipiri don't start till the 6th, the 8th, sometimes not even till the 12th of June. Pipiri is June-lie, because that's the period that it'll extend over.
Our understanding of astronomy is more organic. And I really liked how he talked about that. It made it really accessible, that information, to so many people in the audience. Like, I could just hear murmurings all through. Yeah, I understand that,
It's taking the kōrero of our tūpuna, making it relevant to today.
There's always been empirical science embedded within traditional Māori knowledge. And all Indigenous knowledge is systems. They have empirical science. You don't traverse that expanse of ocean without having science. You don't live in a place like this and thrive without having science. They had science. The difference is it's embedded and encompassed within traditional and cultural narrative. And unless you understand the language and the narrative, you're not going to be able to decode the science.
Today, you go into any 101 astronomy class in the world, they will say to you, we are all stardust. All of the elements that make up you and me begins its life within a star. We're all related. All the elements of life were stuck together in this tight embrace that exploded outwards. You tell me how that's different from how Tāne separated Rangi and Papa, or how that's different from us understanding we have genealogy to everything. It's just that ours is wrapped in a cultural narrative, so we have a connection to it.
Māori had built this narrative that engaged just really well with modern science and the way that we see the universe and the cosmos and so on. So it's just fantastic. And it's just fabulous that he's able to take that out into the community and take that message and get people interested and excited about it.
This photo is from Hākari Mata, which is above Waikato. We used to carry and do our ceremonies up there until we got tired of this killer walk. Now we drive. We drive to another location, but a beautiful view that morning of the cluster in the night sky.
My ancestor who wrote the manuscript that I had was a friend of Elston Best, who was part of the Royal Society. They spent some time together in Ruatahuna in the middle of the Uruwera forest. And over 100 years later, I reconnected with the Royal Society, Te Aparangi. And when I did bring the idea of the roadshow, they just jumped straight on it. And we talked about the connections. So it's an old connection that has been made new again. So it's really important. It's really cool.
I've never learned about the stars before. I love astronomy, and I actually learned a lot about my culture.
Tonight's been really awesome, and I'm grateful that I've come along and, supported and got a book to, continue, learning.
And something that I'm really keen to get more into and learn more, and I think that this things like this are a really great way to start.
The curiosity and the passion for the knowledge that's been lost and the knowledge that they're bringing back, it was stunning.
So when you go outside, look up. Ka nui te mihi ki a koutou katoa, tēnā koutou.